News review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we show you how to use the language from the latest news stories in your everyday English. Hi, I'm Neil. Joining me is Dan. Hello, Dan.
Hello.
What's our story?
Our story is about an official apology.
Okay, an official apology. Let's find out more from this BBC World Service news bulletin.
The Canadian Prime Minister, Justin Trudeau, has formally apologised for the hanging in the 19th century of a group of Indigenous leaders by the British colonial authorities. In 1864, five First Nation chiefs were tried and hanged over the killing of 14 white settlers after coming to what they thought were peace talks. Mr Trudeau said he hoped the apology would help to heal relations with the Tshilhqot’in people.
So, in 1864, five First Nation chiefs, those are of the peoples indigenous to Canada, went to what they thought were peace talks to end a war in what is now British Columbia. The British colonial authorities took them, tried them, and hanged them for allegedly killing 14 white settlers. In the present, current Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau has officially apologised for this act and hopes that relations with the Tshilhqot’in people will improve.
OK, well, you've been looking around at this story and picked out three words and expressions being used in the news that we can use in our everyday English. What are they?
Exonerates, unjustly and overdue.
OK, exonerates, unjustly and overdue. Let's have a look at your first headline with exonerates.
Certainly. Our first headline comes from The Guardian and says, Justin Trudeau exonerates six Indigenous chiefs who were executed.
Exonerates officially states someone is not guilty.
That's correct. Now, exonerates is a verb. There is a noun form, exoneration, but we don't hear it very much. And what's interesting is the word comes from Latin and it's a prefix with a root word. In fact, all of our words today are prefixes with root words, so that's really cool. So we have the prefix, which is ex, meaning off or out, and we have onerous or onerate, which comes from the Latin meaning heavy or burden. So to remove the burden of a crime. Now, what's really cool is that a person in authority is the one who can exonerate you. So we're talking about judges or royalty or someone in an official position. And officiality and formality is a very strong part of this word.
Yeah, it's strongly connected to justice and the law, isn't it?
Exactly that. So formal, political or legal contexts only. You can be exonerated for past crimes, and that's an expression or a set of words that we often hear, maybe because new evidence shows that somebody was not guilty in an old case, or it's possible that someone is being forgiven because the law has changed.
Are there any other words similar to this we could use?
I'm glad you ask. We can use acquit, we can use absolved, and we can use pardoned.
Okay. Now, all of these are, as we said, connected to sort of processes, legal official processes. So if, for example, I came home one day and there was food all over the floor and I grabbed my kids and I said, I told you before, don't be so messy when you're eating. And they said, wasn't us, it was the dog. Could I then exonerate the children?
Well, if you were kind of being comical or ironic, then yes, of course you could. But to be honest, in an everyday sense, we would choose forgiven or let off. So you can let the children off or you can forgive them.
Moving on to our next headline then.
Our next headline comes from the Globe and Mail and says, Trudeau exonerates six BC First Nation chiefs unjustly hanged 154 years ago. And of course, BC here stands for British Columbia, which was where this all happened.
Okay, unjustly meaning unfairly.
Correct. Now, again, we have another prefix and root word combination. So we have the prefix un, which means not, and just, which is the root of the word, and also the root of the word justice, and that means morally right according to a higher authority.
For example, the law.
For example, the law. And you see the adverb, because unjustly is an adverb, you see the adverb unjustly used in all sorts of word combinations. We can talk about people being sentenced unjustly. We can talk about someone being unjustly accused. We can talk about convicted unjustly or even unjustly convicted. It can go in position either before or after. And this leads us to another set of words which is extremely common in this context, and that's called a miscarriage of justice. And this happens when, for example, there isn't enough evidence to convict someone properly, but maybe due to corruption or something along those lines, they get convicted of a crime which they may not have committed.
Okay, well, as you have pointed out, this is often connected to justice. It's got that word just in it. But it's got a kind of wider usage than, for example, exonerate, which we looked at earlier, just to mean unfairly. So, for example, the footballer, you could say, did you see the game? Smith, he got sent off.
Yes, he was unjustly sent off. Yeah. He didn't actually do anything wrong.
The other guy dived, didn't he?
He totally took a dive, yeah.
Okay, so we're not talking about the law here, but we're talking about the rules of a game, football.
Yes.
And so it can be used to talk about unfairness.
Exactly. In some context, it's closer to unfair than it is to talking about a miscarriage or where justice has not been served. And also, I apologize for unjustly accusing you this morning of stealing my cake.
Yes, indeed. Although it did look from the crumbs on my keyboard like I had stolen your cake, it was in fact Rob.
Rob. It's always Rob.
It's always Rob who steals the cake.
I think he put them there on purpose to throw me off.
But it was unjust.
It was unjust.
For you to accuse me.
I apologize. You are exonerated.
You thank you. And that was ironic. And let's take a look now at our third headline.
Our third headline comes from the National Observer and says, Trudeau delivers long overdue apology to exonerate six Tshilhqot’in chiefs who were unjustly hanged.
Okay, we got exonerates and unjustly. We've also got overdue, which means should have happened already.
Exactly. Now, overdue is an adjective, and again, it's another root and prefix combination. So we have the prefix over, meaning too much or too long. For example, you might oversleep in the morning, so you sleep too long, or you can overcook a chicken, so you cook it too much.
If we talk too much, we could overrun.
Exactly. There we go. Our program may overrun. Then, of course, we have the root of the word. So we have due, i.e. happening soon or coming soon. And often on electronic bus stops, you might see the word the bus is due, i.e. it's coming very soon. So overdue, meaning too much, coming soon, or in this case, should have happened already.
Yeah, and we see this word in a number of contexts. Most commonly, I would say, about library books. If you borrow a book from the library and you take it back after it should have been returned, you could call it overdue. Babies, you get a due date when the child is supposed to be born. If it happens after that, you call it overdue.
Mm. And anything basically with a deadline, really.
Yeah. So essays,
mm.
University students will be familiar with the concept of the overdue essay.
Much like the script this morning, it was overdue by 10 minutes.
It was.
Yeah.
But we'll talk about that another time. Before we recap the vocabulary, of course, we have our Facebook challenge, and we set this question for our Facebook followers. The Canadian Prime Minister has formally apologised for the 1864 hanging of a group of First Nation leaders. These chiefs were the leaders of groups of people who naturally existed in that land before settlers arrived. Which adjective below describes this? Is it A, ingenious, B, indigenous, or C, indignant? How was the answer?
Well, it seems that everybody got the answer right. The correct answer is, of course, B, indigenous. I would like to say well done to a lot of individuals, but unfortunately, there are too many correct answers. However, one answer is particularly nice from Yasmin Sophie, and she says, ingenious is clever, original and inventive. Indigenous is relates to native people, and indignant is feeling or showing anger or annoyance at what is perceived as unfair treatment. B is the correct answer. Well done, Yasmin. Very nice answer to us. Thank you.
Yes, well done, everyone. And now just that vocabulary recap, please.
So our first was exonerates, officially states someone is not guilty. Secondly, we had unjustly, unfairly. And finally, overdue, should have happened already.
If you'd like to test yourself on that vocabulary, there's a quiz you can take on our website at bbclearningenglish.com, where there's all kinds of other videos and activities to help you improve your English. Thank you for joining us, and goodbye.
Goodbye.
News review from BBC Learning English.